Patient, we were supposed to be rolling hours ago. It's 1 o'clock. Let's roll, please. I need to get a lot of stuff done today. I need you rolling, please. Okay, Matt, I need you on mark, please. Oh my God.
I know.
There's no vodka in the area, is there?
There we go. Now it's not. Look how
fucking. Walking in the rain.
It's watery.
Okay, so I need you to slate and spell your name so the people who are challenged.
Or Matt Bolton, MattBolton.
And what title do you want below yourself?
I am a light worker.
A light worker?
I don't know.
Okay. Well, do you want to be president of Doodah Records? I don't know.
I want to represent my company.
That's why I'm asking you. What do you want to be? Humanitarian? Concerned citizen?
Canadian citizen.
Canadian citizen. Okay. Yeah, you really have to stand on the mark, otherwise it'll fuck it up. Because we're going to be putting Amazon and other footage behind you, and the only way we can do it is if you stay spot on, because when you start to move, it changes the light. It'll be a color correction nightmare. Oh, yeah. Yeah, he's talking. You're talking to people. You're not. You don't even.
Come here and check these shots.
Great. That's fine. You don't even want to show his nipples. I see you cut his chest off. So, Matt.
I'm really nervous.
Hey, baby. He's got your face up tight. He's on your face, baby. So, Matt, what would you say if you... Anytime we can start would be great, folks. Please. Matt, what would you say if you knew that for 50 years... No. I'm fine. Why do you want me here? But I'm not, I told him, look at the camera, not me. Please, let me direct. Please let me direct. Thanks. Matt, what would you say if you heard that global leaders knew for the last 50 years how to stop global warming and didn't because the money was more important than the people in the future? You don't have to edit yourself. Be real.
I am.
Okay.
How do I want to answer that one?
I know, it's a real serious question.
You want me to come back to that
I'd
one?
I'd say the leaders of this world reflect the population of this world. So if we really want our leaders to change their thoughts, the majority of the population would have to change their thoughts as well. So in order for really for our leaders to reflect positive people, well, then the people have to be positive.
Well put. So they knew 50 years ago how to stop this, but they thought we would have the technology to stop it today, which we don't. And now they made an announcement this year that we can only go up 2 degrees more centigrade, where sea levels raise 200 to 300 feet, eradicating most island countries in Los Angeles and low-lying cities. And we only have maybe 5 years to correct this. How does it feel?
It feels accurate. But like I said, again, the answer for this question, I would say, would be the sense of the sense that, you know, we have leaders that are making decisions based on what they think is best for themselves and everyone else. And if their decisions are driven by greed or some sort of negative emotion, then that is because that the average person would make the same decision. We vote for these people because they're like us, and we vote for people that are like us. And if people like us are in power, then they're going to make making decisions like us, generally speaking. So like I said before, if you really want our leaders to change, we need to change ourselves first.
So, 2 years ago, they found a violet in the rainforest, which is now the cure for children's leukemia. Had they thrashed over it like they're doing everything else in the rainforest, we wouldn't know about it. We've discovered less than 1% of the rainforest and its potential cures. yet we are tearing it down faster than we can even discover. What would you say to people who are ripping shit apart?
I'd say, there's nothing that I could say that it would stop any type of momentum in any circles in the government wise. But what I can say to the people would be to rise up. If you can, if you have the balls, do what you can to be able to make the difference and put out the information so everyone's aware of what's going on. But there is no changing what's already set in motion. The only way to actually move it is to switch gears from the source. And there is no changing people's minds in government. All they're going to do is deflect and defer. That's what businessmen do, and that's what the government does. So, and I say nothing. There's nothing I can say other than do your research as a person, make your own opinions, and do your own blogs to be able to spread the information that you think is correct.
So Gandhi said, be the change you want to see in the world. And for those who feel completely disempowered, I mean, I'm just one person, what can I do? Any suggestions what one person can do to empower themselves to take action?
Eat fresh fruits and vegetables, meditate, work out, have a positive attitude, and engage in positive conversations with people that have influence.
What about pesticides?
Don't eat them.
Ah, what about food products with words you can't pronounce?
Look them up.
And if it says it's not real?
Don't believe it.
Oh, eat it anyway. It's Doritos. Okay, good. Yeah.
Well, don't eat Doritos. They're bad.
Thank God they're not going to be a sponsor now. fuck Doritos.
Delete that. I like Doritos.
Oh, yeah. We bring the Doritos back. And some Sky Vodka. Okay. So, right now, the devastation is happening so rapidly that they said 2 degrees centigrade. Actually, what happened this year is we went up almost a full degree centigrade. So we're less than 1.2 centigrade away. And by the way, it was 165 degrees in the Middle East this summer.
Okay. Good thing I don't live in the Middle East.
How would you deal with 165 degrees in Los Angeles?
Wear a hat.
Okay. Or be baking in the sun in 3 seconds. So, what about recycling?
Do it.
Do you do it?
Try to.
Do you lead by example?
I follow me, man. I know how to do shit.
I've seen the big recycle bins at your house.
I recycle a lot. I also throw a lot of parties, so we just recycle a ton of stuff.
Why is recycling so important, aside from the CRV value?
More than anything, recycling shows the world that you care. That's the most important thing. The positivity that people view you caring about the planet influences more people to care about the planet. That's the most important thing. The actual action of recycling itself doesn't make any difference. I have to take this.
Tell Mom I said hi.
Hi, guys. Michael.
You can pause.